What if London didn't just extend its underground? What if it reconnected the whole city? Picture a single tube line from Camden Town to Eltham, King's Cross to Camberwell, Holborn to Peckham Rhee, Waterloo to Lewisham, linking the capital's busiest hubs to nearly a million people in southeast London still waiting for a proper connection. This line doesn't exist. No formal plan, no political support. And maybe that's exactly the problem. Because it could address three of London's biggest failures: underserved southeast communities, overloaded central stations, and disconnected rail networks. So here's the question. Could the Camden-Eltham line be the bold rethink London's transport desperately needs? Or is it just another visionary idea that never leaves the drawing board? London's tube map is iconic, but south of the Thames, it tells a different story. No underground in Camberwell, none in Peckham, and across the boroughs of Lewisham, Bexley, and Bromley, nearly a million people share just one tube station. Buses are packed, rail services are patchy, and southeast London faces a transport gap the city's north solved decades ago. Plans like the Fleet Line, Cross River Tram, and Bakerloo Extension have all stalled, leaving this half of the city behind. Enter the Camden-Eltham Line, a bold, speculative shot through the capital's core. From Camden Town, it links King's Cross, Holborn, Waterloo, then drives south, hitting Elephant and Castle, Camberwell, Peckham Rhee, North Cross Gate, Lewisham, Kidbrook, and Eltham. The goal? Close southeast London's equity gap, ease central congestion, and build a true north-south tube spine. No rail transfers, no slow buses. And this isn't just another line. It's a chance to rebalance London's network and reconnect a part of the city long left waiting. A new tube line doesn't just move people, it reshapes entire neighborhoods. The Camden-Eltham line would thread together London's overlooked growth corridors, unlocking up to 30,000 homes and opening doors to over 100,000 jobs. Camberwell hasn't had a rail station since 1916, yet it's home to a major hospital, a leading art school, and a growing population, all relying on overcrowded buses. A tube stop could turn Camberwell into a thriving hub again, bringing back life to the high street and supporting local hiring through community-led development deals. Peckham Rhee, creative, diverse, and buzzing, has 70,000 residents, but no rapid transit. With a tube link, it becomes a business and cultural hotspot, giving locals a 20-minute ride to the West End's job market. Safeguards like resident-led cooperatives can help ensure gentrification doesn't force people out. At Kidbrook, thousands of new homes have risen on the old Ferrier estate, but without strong connections, it risks becoming another isolated estate. A tube station would make it a true transit village, linked, lively, and sustainable. Lewisham, already a major node, becomes the south central spine, boosting offices, education, and commerce. And Eltham, often overlooked and underconnected, gets a fast 25-minute link to the heart of the city, reviving its high street and restoring opportunity. Like I said, this line doesn't just fill in a map. It actively creates new momentum for housing, education, health, and culture. From Camberwell to Eltham, each stop becomes a launchpad for inclusive, long-term growth. And together, they help rebalance the capital, connecting the places that London forgot. London doesn't just need more trains. It needs smarter, faster ways to move people. And that's exactly what the Camden-Eltham line offers. Start at Camden Town, where the Northern line is bursting at the seams. A new southbound route gives it critical breathing room. From King's Cross to Waterloo, two of Britain's busiest rail terminals, it creates a direct 10-minute link. That alone could cut 10,000 peak hour transfers, easing crowding at Bank by up to 12% across the Victoria, Northern, and Jubilee lines. Further south, it tackles the chaos on southeastern main lines. Commuters from Eltham, Kidbrook, and Lewisham squeeze into packed trains crawling into London Bridge and Cannon Street. A high-frequency tube gives them a reliable alternative and gives National Rail a vital pressure valve if the network stalls. At New Cross Gate in Peckham Rhee, new interchanges with the overground allow riders from Crystal Palace to Croydon to bypass Zone 1 entirely, reaching King's Cross without clogging London Bridge or Victoria. And by redistributing passengers, the line relieves some of London's most stressed interchanges. Holborn and Bank, both facing multi-million pound rebuilds to deal with overcrowding, gets crucial relief. Not through expansion, but smarter routing. Again, this line doesn't just fill gaps, it flips the city's transport logic. A vertical spine through the capital, a new path from suburb to center, and a powerful upgrade to the way London connects. Tunneling a new deep level tube line from Camden to Eltham is no small feat, but it's entirely within reach. Twin bore tunnels stretching 15 to 20 kilometers would pass beneath central London and cross the Thames near Waterloo Bridge. South of the river, London clay provides ideal conditions, but Lewisham's mixed ground will require meticulous geotechnical work. With an estimated cost between 10 and 15 billion pounds comparable to the Thames Link program, careful design and delivery strategy are essential to keep costs contained. Crossing the Thames presents one of the biggest technical hurdles. Avoiding sediment disruption and threading between riverside foundations demands the kind of precision seen in the Battersea extension. Microtunneling near heritage assets, particularly around King's Cross, would be vital to minimize risk. Central stations like King's Cross, Holborn, and Waterloo will require deep excavations, 30 to 40 meters down, to thread beneath existing lines and utilities. This brings disruption, especially at Holborn, where station upgrades are already planned. But with coordination, the new works could dovetail with existing projects, reducing redundancy and disruption. Good planning makes all the difference. Tying in with Camden Town station rebuild avoids duplicated efforts. Using low-carbon concrete and reusing tunnel spoil for construction align the project with TfL's climate goals. Modern tunnel boring machines, like those used for Crossrail, will help limit surface impact across the route. In South London, new stations at Camberwell and Peckham Rhee would be simpler, taking advantage of open land and railway-adjacent plots to anchor regeneration. At New Cross Gate, proximity to existing overground tracks ensures seamless interchange and helps relieve pressure at London Bridge. At the southeastern end, Eltham offers a cost-effective terminus. A surface depot near Mottingham could serve the line efficiently, potentially decked over to create green space or housing, blending function with community value. With the 10 to 12 year timeline and a blueprint drawn from Crossrail and the Jubilee line extension, this line is bold, complex, and entirely buildable. The Camden-Eltham line isn't just for today, it's built for the London of 2125. Automation comes standard. Platform screen doors and CBTC signaling enable driverless trains every 90 seconds, pushing peak capacity to 40 trains per hour. That's up to 150,000 daily riders, cutting crowding on the Northern Line by as much as 15%, and bringing high-frequency service to communities long left off the tube map. Lower operating costs also help keep fares affordable. Sustainability is baked in. Regenerative braking cuts energy use by 20%, while solar panels atop the Eltham Depot feed power back into the system. Heat mitigation comes via groundwater cooling and advanced tunnel ventilation, technologies tested on the Elizabeth Line, ensuring comfort as summers grow hotter. Flood protection borrows from the Jubilee Line extension. Deployable gates at Thames-adjacent stations guard against storm surges and rising water levels. The infrastructure is smart from day one. Digital signaling and real-time diagnostics keep services reliable. Crossovers and turnbacks are built in to maintain flexibility and ensure partial operation during incidents. Stations like Peckham and Lewisham are future-ready too, with safeguarded entrances for expected growth in their opportunity areas. And it doesn't just stop there. The line is designed to extend north to Brent Cross or southeast to Bexley without expensive rework. Every tunnel, turnout, and platform leaves room to grow. This line would be a testbed for what comes next. Resilient, sustainable, equitable infrastructure designed not to catch up with London, but to pull it forward. So how does the Camden-Eltham line measure up? At an estimated 10 to 15 billion pounds, it's more ambitious than the 3 to 5 billion Bakerloo line extension, but far more affordable than the 30 billion pound price tag for Crossrail 2. It could serve around 200,000 daily passengers, surpassing Bakerloo's 150,000 and vastly outpacing the West London Orbital's 30,000. With potential to ease Northern Line crowding by up to 15%, its network impact rivals Crossrail, but with sharper focus on underserved areas. On regeneration, it unlocks 20,000 to 30,000 new homes across Camberwell, Peckham, and Lewisham, comparable to the Bakerloo extension, but in areas facing deeper deprivation. Where Crossrail 2 targets a blend of affluent and outer suburban zones, Camden-Eltham focuses squarely on transport equity. It also takes lessons from London's past megaprojects. Crossrail's phased rollout suggests a Camden-Lewisham first stage, scaling to Eltham later. Bakerloo's grassroots momentum shows the value of early buy-in from Southwark and Lewisham councils. The West London Orbital reminds us that smart reuse, like siting a surface depot near Eltham, can keep costs down. And just like the Northern Line extension leveraged land value at Battersea, this line could draw funding from Peckham's soaring development potential. In short, Camden-Eltham strikes a rare balance. More impactful than Bakerloo, more targeted than Crossrail 2, and more transformative than the Orbital. It's the missing spine London never built, linking north and south, center and suburb, with infrastructure that finally reflects the needs of all Londoners. So, what do you think? Is this the line London's been waiting for? Could Camden-Eltham finally stitch together the city's most underserved boroughs with its busiest hubs? Or is it just a fantasy that's destined to gather dust alongside the Fleet Line and the Cross River Tram? We'd love to hear your take. Would you ride it? Would it change your commute? Drop your thoughts in the comments. And if you enjoyed this speculative deep dive into London's possible future, check out our other videos on citywide projects like the new Grand Paris Express or Cairo Metro. And don't forget to subscribe to Urban Giants for more grounded, globally minded takes on the world's boldest infrastructure ideas. Because the future of cities is being drawn right now, sometimes in ink, sometimes in tunnel boring machines.